I bet you've never seen a streamer using PostFX that looks like this. That's right, there's no trickery of editing here. My game actually looks this good. Today I'm going to show you the best overall PostFX settings you can use across all maps. No more changing your settings each raid to make sure it's perfect. This is truly something I believe all players can benefit from. Stop. Whatever you're doing. And listen to this. PostFX settings aren't actually as important as you think. Where the majority of people go wrong is configuring the color settings on their monitor, which if you've got an Nvidia graphics card, can be done in the control panel as shown on screen. Before you even attempt using these PostFX settings, please make sure you mess around with your color settings because there's a lot of visibility to be gained by doing this. Not only that, but the PostFX filter I'm going to use actually adapts to your Nvidia control panel settings. Because this PostFX filter is emphasizing the range of colors you see, it means you're going to get way more contrast and clarity, allowing you to easily define objects even in the darkest of places in Tarkov. On screen now is a very shaky example of me changing my Nvidia color settings from default to my preferred settings, and in addition, I'm using this quote-unquote night vision mode, but all this is really doing is turning up your gamma. And finally, with the PostFX filter. Please don't skip out on this process. Although my phone camera quality isn't amazing, you can see how well it lit up some of the darkest places in Resort. And if you're looking at my gameplay and thinking, I can't see anything, the chances are your gamma settings are way too low on your monitor. Now let's take a look at the settings. Before you click away and try this for yourself, it's important to know why we aren't using certain sliders and which ones I recommend tweaking to get the results that work for you. Let's crack on. Don't use brightness. This adds loads of bloom to the game when it's sunny, and it'll also turn up how bright flashlights are for both you and the enemy, rendering them basically useless and blinding. Saturation and colorfulness. Both of these need to be on 100. This is because it renders more color in game, allowing for better definition. If it's too vibrant, that's fine. Just turn down the digital vibrance slider in the Nvidia control panel to your liking, but make sure these two sliders are maxed out in your PostFX. Clarity. If you like using clarity, go ahead. It can help you see further at range when it's foggy, but I've noticed it will tank my FPS by about 10 to 15. Luma Sharpen. This will brighten up the surfaces of certain things, make foliage in game look sharper. This setting is optional as well, as it can affect your FPS on certain maps, but I'd recommend using it anyway. Adaptive Sharpen. This is optional, but I don't use it. Now the color grading filter we're going to be using is called Montreal. Keep it at 100. And the last option, which makes my trees so green, is this colorblind mode here. I really like this because by default, trees are a horrible mix between yellow and green. Play around with the slider though, because it can change how things look inside of buildings too. I prefer to keep mine around 63. I understand it's not for everyone, but it provides a huge tactical advantage, so it's worth considering. Anyway, back to this color filter. The reason Montreal is so good is because it brightens up the overall image without adding any bloom, and it also recolors some of the washed out yellows to a more blue hue. This is great because it's adding contrast between objects that wasn't previously there, allowing us to pick out other colors easier, for example a PMC. And by far the best part about this filter is how seamlessly it works going from outside to indoors, where it can sometimes take a second for your game to adjust. This filter seems to remove that adjustment. Not only that, but look how much more definition there is between the objects in dark areas. As I said before, this filter emphasizes the color range we're presented, and so by changing the contrast, gamma, and brightness in your Nvidia control panel, we can get a way more fluid experience playing Tarkov. No more messing around with your PostFX. Spend the time setting it up right once and forget about it.